What's up, folks, and welcome back to Star Trek New Horizons. I'm back at Stellaris. It's been a long time since I've actually played. I didn't even get the new DLC. I don't know if it's good or bad or whatever. We are just going to get into an amazing adventure, and I do hope you are going to enjoy it together with me. Keep in mind, I'm in a new room, so it is still very echoing. And I will do my best to fill this room up ASAP, but it will still cost me a few months. Guys, how have you been? It's been ages. It has been ages. But here we go. Our ruler, Nathan Samuel, and the Federal Republic. We are egalitarian, so faction influence plus 25. Specialist pop resource output plus 5. Xenophile, so we kind of like everyone. With trade value plus 10 and the diplomatic influence cost negative 25. We are pacifistic. I never thought about playing another pacifistic empire, but still, we had a lot of fun in the previous run, right? We have administrative capacity plus 10, stability plus 5. We have the civics, drive for self-improvement. Monthly influence plus 10% and supplies negative 10. We have the Spirit of Exploration. Increase the speed with science vessels. Exploration speed with science vessels is increased by 10%. While those unemployed pups living under Ethiopian abundance living standards have increased research. Okay, so unemployment is not a bad thing because they will provide us with unity and research. Surveying speed is plus 10% and we have an additional envoy. We have a temperature preference of just normal, you know, human world planets. We are natural scientists and we are charismatic. Oh yeah. In the spectrum of war following humanity for centuries. Culminating into the Third World War in 2053. Emerging from this post-atomic horror, the people of Earth struggled to survive until the scientist, Zephyrin Coffran, successfully drew the attention of the Vulcan science vessels, the Plumum Math, whatever. And a decade later, he had to wait a decade? Holy crap. Following almost a century of Vulcan patronage, the people of Earth are ready to take their first step into the great unknown. To seek out new life and new civilization, to boldly go where no one has gone before. The epic words. The potential of making ourselves a better man, that is what it is to be human. I do hope so. Let's get started on this. We could go with challenge mode if we want to. But we'll just go with the recommended 100%. Challenge will eventually come, but like I said, I have not played this in a while, so I'm very relying on you. The map is insanely huge, and I've been told that Stellaris has definitely increased its work on the performance, and performance once was my Achilles heel. I really hated the performance. What shall we go for? Deuterium. It's producing, but it's so expensive. So I'm thinking about, let's go for warp. Let us definitely go with the colony ship. And Pangram mine and station, they will harm the planet, as you can see over here. So you don't want to place them just anywhere. The uranium forge. Upkeep, that is quite high. We don't need these for our stations just yet. We don't make any of them, actually. Let's go with the polarized hull plating, because I remember from previously that in order for us to definitely take the... let's go with just... Wrong ship. Here you go. Now, you listen to me, buddy. You listen to me. I want you to... Not this band. I want you to go and assist research. No, let us survey. That's what we are looking for here. Survey, holding shift, and we'll take a look what is around Earth. Now, we don't have any highways, so it will be difficult to find choke points. And hopefully we won't be into a position where we actually need them. I'm going to be sending
infinite combination.
Can I send an envoy towards you? Espionage. Never looked into this. Like I said, I don't have anything else. I don't have the new DLC. Let's improve relations. Apparently unacceptable. Well, that is just lovely, isn't it? We'll have to take a look on where to send our ships. We need to get more ships. Strength is power. Or power is strength. Unyielding? Oh, the audio is really loud again. Ship firing rate. Let's go with this guy. And before I do anything else, let's go back into sound options and drop down the music volumes, because I kind of don't want any copyright issues. I can't remember how that was last time. So you are done. Anything I want to build over here, we can actually go with a trade deep. No, not really, no. We can also just go and do nothing. How does this all look? Oh, definitely changed. Can I still build only one research station on the planet? One of one? Don't even have research buildings. Interesting. So far so good. Do we get jobs from these? No. That means that it's still using the one that it used to use. Wow, that's English. English number one. So I would like to try to keep my economy into the positives, which would be new for me. So we need energy, and the Mars colony eventually will try to make Mars a better place. Any decisions that I could go for right now doesn't look like it's the terraforming one that I would like to go for. Decisions, anything. Not really. So I think it's time. I think it is time that we unpause and let's get to anything. An extra challenge. Oh God. Please note that you will lose no game content by opting into this mode, and it will be disabled at any time by firing event IDs from the console. Sure, let's go for the additional challenge. Whatever, let's take a look how bad allow I can screw myself over. Go away, really Q. Maybe not. Sorry for that, Q. Oh, I forgot I was a social human being.
Did you know?
Go away, Q. I don't want your mineral, go away. Yeah, I forgot completely again. Sometimes I just wear. I'm way too Terran. Let's go and accept that with the Vulcans. Second fleet.
Infinite diversity.
Embassy. Yes. I still feel the audio is a bit too loud here. Yeah, I will be tempering with this a bit. Let's just drop you down. And I usually hate something like this. Doesn't need to be too loud. I can always increase music. I can always decrease music, or well, whatever. A class M. Interesting.
Nothing that is.
Yeah, sure, dude. Just go for it. Just go. Do it. Oh, yeah, it's not annoying at all. Let's go. Accept that. Oh, wow.
Infinite diversity.
Yes, I will. Now, leave me alone. Damn you, Vulcan. Damn you. Let's go. So, Pajam, how strong are you? Unknown. Oh, that's new. Gather information? Interesting. I'll have to look into this at some point. Not right now. Now, I remember that this game could go particularly slow. So, let's take a look into... Oh, the scroll border. Oh, I could turn it off. I've been told. I can tell that the one thing that I've hated the most was this one. Apply. Yes. Yes, no more scrolling like that. Thank you. Oh, these devs guys are amazing. Edicts. I will probably go into a colonization thing or research. One or the other. Let's make sure that we don't pause. Let's go to ship designer. We have the auto best frigate. It looks cool, though. It does look cool. It is all the best. There's the scout. Do we have any of these? Do we want any of those? It will make the ship more expensive, but also stronger. Colony ship is done. Let's go with... Well, it is nice getting some luxuries, but it's not that needed, and I kinda hate this one, because it's not there. It's not on all of your planets, and once I get that, we can also import it. Oh, let's just take it, whatever. Okay, let's go back to ships. Construction. So it is currently using double armor plating as well as bulkheads. Interesting. Science. Any other thing that we want on this? Definitely. Here you go. Take that. Crew pods. Daily regen or hull Anomaly points. Detected. This is, I think, the scientist. Research it. Emergency backup systems. Don't really need that, no. Will you save this? Turn that off. Save the Franklin. And let's go towards the construction ship. Anything that will actually help me? No. So we'll keep that one on. Scout is on there as well. The scientist we already had. Scout. It is using the pulse cannons. Now, we don't really have any other weapons now, do we? Nuclear torpedoes. Is it better? I think the cooldown is 4 and this one is 7 still. 5 to 17 or 10 to 32. Now the cooldown is 7, so yeah, I would assume that this will have to be twice as good. So that's 20, that would be 43. Actually, it's not that far off. In terms of pricing, oh well, we'll just leave things the way. We want to get rid of nuclear. Come on, we are the Federation. We're goody goods. Do we have other... I kind of like the torpedo one though. Because this is more hull damage and this one is more shield damage. So getting a bit of a balanced thing, I do enjoy more. That is all gone. This looks good. Save this. That means that we can already upgrade our ships and we will be spending 40 alloys. Let's do it. Let's go to our shipyard. Let's get the additional shipyard. Okay, so a matter of time. The source of the chronicle particles appears to be traceable to a small vessel in orbit of the Bernard Star Third. Not the Third, it's Bernard Star Third. Free. Bernard for free, whatever. Sensors are unable to penetrate the hull and appears to be adrift. Let's open hailing frequencies. The vessel responding to the hail. Captain, please move. About 1 meter to your right. Confused, the captain moves aside as a human materializes on the bridge. Excellent. Now, my name is Professor because I cannot pronounce these. And I've traveled back in time 2 centuries to study the crew of the USS Franklin. To the exploits of the ships and the captain are legendary in my time. See. Sad. We can assist the historian since the Federation isn't formed yet, so we don't have the prime director to go with time, so let's assist. So the scientist, time on the USS Franklin was difficult to many of the crew, a constant stream of questionnaires, and her not to be subtle condescensions do little to interrogate. The English. After a while, the captain strikes up a conversation with the time traveler and had to discuss United Earth history up to a current year. Eventually, the historian declares her research complete and prepares to depart. And apparently, well, it's unfortunate that sometimes I'm brave is dead. Oh, it sucks to be you now, doesn't it? Yeah, provide her services. So we'll get a scientist. So let's go to... Where's my leader tab? Let's leave the tab. That means we have 2 more. So here's the scientist who is a genius. She is a genius. We do want to get 2 more ships. Before we do anything else, let's go to shipyard and we'll go with 2 science ships. Let's go to research. Where do we want a... We have a lot of in society actually. Doing a lot of engineering apparently, but I kind of want to get... Engineering is nice because there's also the... I believe the shipyards and the ships come from engineering. But this one's already having 17, so I don't really see the need to change this. I kind of do think that... C is not the best researcher. Leader lifespan plus 25 could be useful. Not as useful right now. So, plus 18, that will help me with my society. If we could get another... scientist, that is just as good, which we apparently can't. But there is Jonathan Archer. We'll get him, not right now, since we don't have the Enterprise yet. No, the rest aren't that, not that useful. Can we recruit you and do science? Let's take a look here. Ship weapon damage, supply speed, firing rate, accuracy, surveying speed. No, we got a doggy. Does not help. And I kind of don't want him dead. Oh well. Let's just let's continue and ships get upgraded. Those ships are now upgraded. That means that we'll get two scientists quite soon. And we'll save up on resources because we don't need to spend them. But like I said, what I do want to do is make sure that we get our ship, our fleet power up. We are on Grand Admiral. For those of you who don't know what I usually do, we are on Grand Admiral and the rest are just the normal options. So we don't have an over aggressive AI, but we are on the challenge difficulty. And I'm not particularly sure how that will go, but we will see. I wish there was a faster speed still. But, anomaly detected. Yeah, research that. You. Let's go take you. And I want you to survey. There. There. Yeah, stay around. It's fine. It is fine. Now, we have the other ship as well. And we'll get her on that. And I want you to head towards... this range. Actually, no. Belay that. I want you to move there and survey into the area of other Federation founders, because I believe they are in this range. If we can find them right now and we can ally them and get them into unknown origin. Infiltration progress daily. It is not increasing. We can build up spy network. That is so cool. That is very cool, actually. I do like construction that. Construction complete. Okay, so we got the second shipyard on the Sol base. We got the polarizing hull. And... armory gen evasion is nice for small ships. Supply speed is also quite okay. But main engineering console. Let's go for that. Second fleet can upgrade once again. We're not going to. Let's go to our... fleet manager, and let's just add 12 of these, since that is the maximum of this fleet. 12 ships. We have 4 now at 114, so it could be enough. We'll have to see about that. We need more than 1,000 alloys. Actually, that is not that expensive. It really isn't. We'll just haul off. We are probably only going to places which we can actually use fruit. Plus 10. This planet is horrible. It is horrible. I'll probably just leave it. Well, we have Mars. We have the Sol system. We can actually let the others do all of that. Leader cost negative 12. Or 12. 20. Why do I say 12? Water purifications. Military academy. Import water ice. Educational reforms. I don't think those are too impressive. So let's go with the advanced water purifier. We can also sell some of these. Let's get some alloys and get towards our fleet. Reinforce that. We have forced contact with beta aliens. Now this apparently has changed. Let's go over here. So The AZ system for now beta aliens. How can I change this? Can I set up? Oh, yes, we can. Oh, that is damn good. Felix, you lad, you mad lad. Go for it, dude. You can do this. Be our representative and be amazing. Be amazing about it. He's going over there. You are going over there. You are... I'm very happy that we sent her. So, she's probably pissed about losing her science job. And she just discovered life. Isn't that amazing? That is amazing. Construction ship. Well, we could get this by physics at some point. There's the warp drives. Nice. Optical computer is an increase. Hardening fields is also nice. That will actually get us, I believe, into shields. Because right now, we don't have shields. So let's get hardening fields. Let's see. Yeah, we don't have shields. I kind of want shields. Shields are quite important. Quite important, I say. Oh, come on, man. 5 days. Who are they? Breakthrough chances 40. Okay, that's going to take us a bit. That's fine, that's fine. So she's doing an amazing job. I like those changes. Really do.
If it is real, it is important.
Okay, independent, guarantee independence. Yeah, there we go. So they are overwhelming.
Live long and prosper.
No. Detected. In order for aliens not to think too low of us, we do want to increase our fleets. And it will help you forming the Federation if you are struggling with that. So... yeah, but for now,
if it is real, it is
important. It is fine. They are doing this nevertheless, so it's not like I have a say in it. I think I do want to go towards the Bernard Star. Let's unpause. And can I get some more alloys? I don't want to sell my food. Keep reinforcing that.
Survey complete.
Okay, finally. So you, let's go send you over there. We don't have the alloys yet. We will at some point. Let's take a look how expensive. So we're lacking 11. That is not that much. That is not that much. So we don't definitely don't want to stay clear of research anomalies and all of that. We are humans. So we definitely want to do our utmost best. Now, do we want to increase... the minerals is fine. I'm thinking about alloys currently because we don't have research at the moment. Silent enemy. Trade center could be nice. So this will cost us 2 workers and only 12 minerals. I think we should do this. So with that, let's take a look at the silent enemy. After the day in orbit of Struth. With no progress in locating the source of the unusual subspace raisings. So the captain prepares to give the order to move towards the next survey target. Moments later, the ship sensors detect a surge in subspace activities, followed by the appearance of an alien ship. Let us attempt to follow the ship. We might lose the ship here. Silent enemy, let's hail them. Also... although we have been unable to discover much about the mysterious vessels in the system, the most convincing current hypothesis, based upon its behavior and the patterns, is still undecipherable signals. Spacefaring civilizations, keep at it. You can do it. Stage 3. Discover those aliens. Oh, this changed. Okay, so communicate over repeats all hailing faces, security teams... we are being boarded. Okay, that's not going to end well now, does it? This is a damn dude. So we will get some sign. I'm not going to read all of it because I know I'm a very, very slow reader. And I don't want to have you guys age faster than I read this text. So he dies. Damn bastards. Let's get... actually, this guy is not the bad. Look at that. He has research speed, computering, particles, and propulsion. Let's get you. Let's go to technology. Oh, okay, like that. So he is just... Okay, fine. Whatever, he's not that special then. Let's go get him, the engineer. Just continue and don't get yourself killed, dude. Seriously, don't do it. Let us try the terraforming foundation of Mars. Now, guys, one question. Should I... Is this going on right now? Guarantee has been revoked. I think we are... They're no longer
challenge
like...
Challenge your preconceptions or they will challenge you.
And I... Let's assign you over there to actually improve relations. And there is the water purifier. Science station sounds absolutely fantastic. We also need to take a look at naval cap. Now, it's just over by a few. And it will be a bit more. Because I will continue technology building...
Discovered.
Unless we get anchoring. Defensive part, we don't have any need for that. Should we go... Yeah, let's go towards light cruisers. New ships, why not? We'll get more alloys in a second.
Anomaly detected.
Let's research this class 12 asteroid. Construction ship. Build a base. Build a base over there. What do you want? One of my dogs is driving attention right now. He's trying to hug me. Go away. Go away, doggy. Okay, let's continue. So, 12 out of... Okay, we can just upgrade what we have right now. 281. That is not a a very good thing. Look at that face of Picard. I love that crew. They're amazing. I just finished Janeway. Voyager. Myself. Can we actually, once we build a starbase.
Survey complete.
Do I have any anchoring? Space depot. Yeah, naval capacity. So I kind of want to do these above stations or above planets that I'm going to occupy. And this is just a horrible planet. We also have Mars, right? Can we build one over... actually, it just goes by system. Okay, maybe we should have changed into the naval capacity. But just getting a new base for that seems more interesting for us. We will definitely continue pushing this to get towards our fleet cap. Actually, his fleet cap. Or we wait. Complete. It's also possible. Construction has been completed, surveying is done. This guy is just doing whatever he can. Breakthrough chance, just 10%. That is nothing. Absolutely nothing. Oh, we got the Gamma Aliens. First contact again. Oh, that is so cool. Let's go. You. Hoffman.
Technology discovered.
Go for it. Amazing human being. Orbital Museum does produce us with Unity. It's one of the buildings I usually go for. We have the Starfleet Intelligence HQ. We will get another Envoy. Outbreaking and stability. Wow. Actually, this is a very, very good building to have. Additional 10% in stability and an Envoy. And if we keep finding aliens like this, we have the first contact protocol, guys. We will find them.
Diversity.
I kind of... You are friendly. Let's form a defensive pack. Which will cost us a lot of influence for now. We will definitely have to mix and manage all of that. Because we will probably find ourselves at a small negative. Until we form the United Federation. Of planets, of course. Okay, so we do need those deuterium plates to upgrade you. Maybe I should get that research, or did we? I don't think we did. Mars, what can I develop you in? No, I can't do this yet. That is a shame. I think we need terraforming first, because it does tell terraforming, right? There's no additional jobs. There is no additional housing. So we can actually do a domed city. Getting plus 5 in housing and a building slot. We will begin the chain. Updated. Let's upgrade that. How is the housing over here? That's more than enough. More than enough. We'll look into these later once we actually know that we'll make a massive surplus, like the luxuries, plus 15. So far, we still have one job remaining, and that is a civilization. They're primitives. If we can go all the way over there, let's build the mining station, actually, before I forget. We can actually build an outpost over there. Colony development speed plus 25 is not a bad idea. Let's go get it.
Survey complete.
Research that. Beta aliens. Let's continue. Anyways, guys, come on, let's pause the game. It's been 30 minutes already. Man, time flies when I'm having fun. I hope you are glad to see Star Trek New Horizons popping back into the channel. I hope you enjoy, and don't forget, really, the first episode is the one that matters the most. Please, please hit that like button, and I'll see you next time. Have a good one. Bye-bye.